Reed. Reed is known to everyone. I don't know why she blew me a kiss, but Chris can't handle it. We'll get to Kevin Durant's return in a second, but first.
Here we go. Junior NBA Girls Division. While CC composes himself, CFA's Aaliyah Carter, no relation to Chris, dropping her opponent to the ground.
What do you mean no relation? They, at the very least, play cousins, probably fourth cousins.
Man, my dad had about 14 to 16 kids when I stopped. Hey, don't be laughing. I'm serious. I stopped counting a long time ago. A lot of kids. Clarence Carter, Papa's a Rolling Stone. For real. I'm just one of them. We got Carters all around the place. We're balling.
Athletics and Rangers. This is Hunter Pence climbing up. Hanging on, grabbing it.
Oh, great timing there. So you got to put your other hand, your free hand up to feel for the fence. Oh, nice. You got to watch those fences like that because they can hurt you, Nick.
Rip my arm open once trying to climb a chain link fence. Had to go to the hospital real bad.
Why were you climbing the fence?
I had to.
Were you stealing something or running from something?
I had to. Move quickly away from people pursuing me, and I end up slicing my body off.
College baseball, UNC's Dallas Fester sprinting, makes a catch, and a flip.
Oh, I'm all about the landing. Watch the landing. Speared that one over the wall. Oh, propels himself to land on his feet.
Mm-hmm.
Nice. He not my cousin, but if he come to the family reunion, though, I'll claim him.
It'll be a hard one to claim, see. But this is a hell of a play. And as you mentioned, I didn't notice that he sticks the landing.
Of course.
Both feet.
I see all things, bro. Okay. All things.
Okay.
All right, moving on. So the last time we saw Kevin Durant on the court was game 5 of the Houston series. After much doubt and many questions surrounding his status and availability to series, it appears KD might be coming back, listed as questionable for tonight after finally practicing yesterday. But according to reports, there's growing confusion and angst among some Warriors regarding KD's return. Nick, what do you make of all this?
Now, this I find fascinating because of who's reporting it. Tim Kawakami in The Athletic, first in a column, wrote the column from a few days ago, wrote the kicker to his column was, while nobody doubts the severity of KD's injury, people around the team are starting to wonder if it were Draymond or Iggy or Steph or Clay, would they have missed a month with a calf strain? And then Sam Amick wrote not a column but a report that alluded to growing angst and frustration and then buttoned it up. But of course, it's not KD's call, it's the trainer's call. But despite that, there's angst among teammates. This is another reason why I think KD has to play tonight, even if it's to show the world, guys, I can't play, because it is the NBA Finals. You saw Klay Thompson miss one game and come back and be great, and there will be maybe totally unfair, but if KD goes this entire Finals without ever stepping on the court, people will ask how hard he was trying to get back on the court. I want to be very clear. I'm not one of those people. I've said from the beginning, there are a lot of things you can question about Kevin Durant. How much he wants to play basketball, how much he cares about basketball.
He is not one of them.
Is not one of them. And I believe Kevin Durant could play and tear both ACLs in the same game and still get a maximum contract from every team in the league. That's available. He's not protecting his money. He's not in that situation. Boogie could have been in that situation where, do I want to risk further injury, something like that. KD is so good and young enough that even if he suffered a significant injury, he'd get the same. The Knicks would offer him the same thing as if he hadn't. So I don't think KD is soft pedaling this or anything, but it would appear some members of the Warriors are a little vexed as to why Kevin Durant has not yet made it back on the court. And that is, to me, a very fascinating dynamic on a team that's had a dozen fascinating dynamics throughout the season.
Tim's a very good reporter. I'm very familiar with him. He covered the Eagles when I came into the league. So been knowing him, knowing of his work for a very, very long time. He is wired into as far as the Warriors. But a lot of these things, they just become sub-stories. Like, is there really a story? Are we questioning Kevin Durant? If he could come back, he wouldn't come back. At the time that he got hurt, he was averaging 34 points, playing 39 minutes. There is one thing that Kevin Durant does better than anything else that he does, and that's play basketball. All right? So if anyone would be able to say, oh, I believe that he would come back and he couldn't come back, you are missing it. The one thing In talking to people who are trying to pursue Kevin Durant, the one thing that they say, they think Kevin Durant's going to play till he's 40 years old. He's a gym rat, loves basketball, loves to get in the game, get to the gym, get up shots. That's what he's loved. Basketball is his thing. Steph talks about how he's a basketball savant. He's a sponge about basketball, talking about basketball, and how it's been a joy to be around KD for the last couple years to see how he's developed his game. So for me, I'm in the group that I know Kevin Durant can't play. Now, do I believe that there are people close to Kevin Durant that would question if it was smart for him to come back? Yes, those type of things happen all the time. But I do not believe Kevin Durant has been available for a month. And I still, when we see Kevin Durant, he will not be the player that we saw in the first round in five games.
He's also a really sensitive guy. You saw how he's had such a hard time handling all the criticism of his move to Golden State, amongst other things. Imagine the backlash that would come, even if they were not true and he didn't get back on the court. I'm not saying he'll rush back because of it, but there's so many things he's probably factoring in with making this decision whether you come back or not.
And it might all be unfair, but you can feel the growing frustration. Steve Kerr finally saying, you know what, I'm not talking about KD's return anymore, I'm just not doing it. The report, I don't remember if it was Kamikami or Sam Amick's report in The Athletic, where they mention there is some, call it confusion amongst the team as to why KD's not on the bench during the games. He's back in the locker room. When Boogie was out on the bench during the games during his recovery, Clay during his one.
Too.
Now it's one game, so it's different. And so I'm not there. I'm not in that locker room. But I also, sometimes a national reporter parachutes in and gives his take on a situation. These guys have been covering the Warriors all year long, Kawakami in particular, and that to me is noteworthy.
And one thing I remember, David West, when he sat here, and said, and we talked to him about this current team. And he said, one of the gems I thought of everything he said, there have been a number of fires behind the scenes that we put out that didn't nobody know about the last couple years.
Yep.
We were able to get, I said, as big as what they went through, and he repeated it. There were a number of fires that we were able to put out behind the scenes. So typically, when you have a group like this, when Jordan was together in his group, there was always a bunch of little stuff. LeBron, we've seen it. Kobe, we've seen it. And now with Golden State, we can't think that it's not going to be there. A little jealousy, a little rumors. Oh, he's getting treated a little bit different. Those are all commonplace with sports.
And what is also commonplace in the NBA is, man, at this time of year, even if you're going to tell me since you've torn your calves it's not possible, the sentiment is, man, gut through it and get out there. The sentiment always is for the NBA in the finals. In the NBA finals, if you are not dead, you're playing. And that's what Steve Kerr said about Clay. They had to fight to keep him out just the one game. And so for KD, when you hear calf strain, and now it's been 30 days, the entirety of the Western Conference Finals, four games of the NBA Finals. This isn't picking on KD.
No.
Any superstar that was out this length of time with this injury, people would start to be saying, man, why is it taking so long for you to get back?
Yes or no? Does he play tonight?
Oh, I think he plays tonight.
Same?
Nope, I'm out.
All right. Take a break coming up. Do the Warriors need more from Steph Curry to beat the Raptors tonight? But it was one word, and I like that.
Chris don't even like doing in or out, but you asked her that direct question, it just is brain fire. Just like, it's not 8:45, but I guess we're doing in or out.